AI is changing the world as we know it. While Alexa, Siri, and Hey Google have been responding to our voices for quite a while now, several companies are making use of AI to conduct more sophisticated tasks. This includes automation, like scheduling and bookkeeping, as well as making predictions about weather, traffic, and other aspects of daily life. In this video, I'm going to break down the different features of the most advanced AI tools in the market. So if you're curious about AI, stay tuned because I'm about to blow your mind. There are three main categories of production-ready AI tools: generators, copywriting, and editors. And there is a new category on the rising, chatbots. But these chatbots are not like those chatbots that companies use to annoy the customers. A few categories are not mainstream yet, as they might require heavy regulations or a more stable AI to prevent putting people's lives at risk. dall-e is a text-to-image generator by OpenAI. It is probably the most known of them all. It works by receiving a text prompt and, after it works its magic, it will provide an image as output. The more detailed is the description, the more detailed is the image. It can also create variations based on the previous images. dall-e is also an image editor. You can erase part of the image, and when you click on Generate, it will understand the context of the image and will apply the text prompt to that specific part that was erased. Not only can it edit existing parts of the image, but it can also extrapolate images by creating data that wasn't previously there. Stable Diffusion is another text-to-image generator. It is open source and its version 2.0 was released by Stability AI last November. That might explain why there are so many generators becoming viral right now, like Avatar AI and Lens AI. Just like dall-e 2, Stable Diffusion receives a description and outputs an image based on the text. Over 2.3 billion images were used to train the Stable Diffusion, and it is the main actor of the image generator tools that are popping up right now. These tools are acting as agents in the middle and writing the prompts to the model for us. So Avatar AI generates avatars based on the images you provide as inputs. People are typically using these avatars in social media, but they can be used for other occasions as well. After the processing time, you receive an email to access the gallery with more than 120 images. Out of these, I considered about 30 to be good enough or usable. The rest were either too far off from what I really look like or pretty weird. Entering the copywriting field, Jasper is a very complete AI tool that helps to create copy and content. In the editor, you can ask Jasper to create content from scratch and refine it along the way. You can also choose the tone of voice, like friendly, casual, or snarky, and keywords that are required to be in the content. If you start with a pre-made text, you can give commands to rephrase, summarize, improve the content, or commands alike. Give structures like outlines, headlines, paragraph, and directions. That is the topic that Jasper will work on top of. It's packed with templates for specific platforms like Google Ads, Amazon, Facebook, YouTube, and for different actions inside those platforms, like product description and ads headlines. These templates basically work as a predefined set of rules that are applied to the editor. Its business model is based on the system of credits, which is seemingly very common in the AI platform tools. Before the internet was widely popular, we sought information in encyclopedias that were sold by a house-to-house salesperson, or we went to physical libraries. But the books were limited to the views of the publisher, and because they were so expensive, it was rare for families to have more than one set of books. So with the advent of search engines, finding information became a more simplified process with a larger variety of perspectives. The more websites were published, the more the search engines indexed them and made this process slightly better on every iteration. Looking from a more distant perspective, the boom of websites fed information to the search engines, and metaphorically, this is how AI works. It needs to be fed with information. ChatGPT is quite revolutionary. With it, you can generate working code in several programming languages. In some programming languages, it can find the issue in the code, explain why it is wrong, provide a solution, and explain the solution, get full description with examples for common issues in the programming languages, spit out a to-do list of basically anything you want with items you wouldn't think of, get cooking recipes, create full scripts for your YouTube videos, and even some advanced technique of how to light a cinematic shot. I also used it to suggest me text prompts to insert into dall-e 2. This tool is so mind-blowing that you gotta try it for yourself to believe. But this is just the beginning. The common intersection between several of these AI companies is OpenAI. Jasper, dall-e, and ChatGPT seem to rely on OpenAI technologies as the main engine of their products. OpenAI has been one of the big names when it comes to artificial intelligence. They state that their goal is to advance digital intelligence in the way that is most likely to benefit humanity as a whole, by focusing on three key areas: research, development, and education. Alongside utility, AI has plenty of open questions yet to be answered. One possible reason why many people believe that the training data for AIs could contain copyrighted material without authorization is because it's quite obscured or not publicly disclosed where the data is sourced from. Thus, it is difficult to rule out the possibility of infringement. On the other hand, many people argue that the AI is simply learning and using the information that is available to it, like it's creating its own content rather than mixing copyrighted material. This makes the line between AI copyright infringement and fair use blurry. Every time a new AI editor or image generator becomes viral, the very same concern about privacy comes attached to it. People get worried that these tools could be used to invade the privacy by allowing others to use their images with shady purposes. So if reading the terms and conditions is not something that we usually do, we should start thinking about doing it for these tools and avoid any potential headaches down the road. According to the creator of Avatar AI, this company should always delete from the servers both the input photos and the generated AI model. Since AI needs to be trained in order to function, this has led to controversy and debate over how best to prevent AI from exhibiting biases in its decision making. Unless there are guidelines or even set of rules on how AI should operate, it is likely that the systems will be biased by the views of the people who are shaping its understanding of the world. Not long ago, Microsoft released an AI on Twitter that would interact with the users to learn to engage with people through casual and playful conversation. In less than a day, the account was made private because the experiment backfired. These are some of the issues that need to be addressed with the AI uprising, and I strongly believe that standards are necessary for how our data can be used and manipulated by AIs. Why AI tools are popular now and why most of them are not cheap, you might ask. They are popular because they can automate tasks and processes that would otherwise be very time-consuming and expensive for us. I would say that the high cost is related to the amount of processing power in the form of faster computers or electricity they require in order to produce the results. That's why AI is often costly. However, it wouldn't be a surprise to see companies that want to maintain a high profit margin when it comes to AI. Now that AI is a buzzword, I have an optimistic view. The computers are essential because they make repetitive mathematical calculations way faster than any human could ever do. But at the end of the day, we operate them. I think that these AIs would do the same, from writing to designs to code generation, but ultimately they will not overcome a more refined look, the capability of imagination and creativity that only we have. This new era is quite exciting, and what these tools can already do is remarkable. What are your thoughts about it? Let me know down in the comments. Are you excited for it? Do you fear it? Or write something that you would like to ask to these AIs. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it, and I see you soon.